We have the compressor division today at the Johannesburg head office, in the I&D division. You can see the warehouse here at the back. My name is Dewald van der Venter. I'm the business development manager for the air division. As you can see here, you've got our own range of reciprocating compressor, our own range of rotary screw compressor being launched now, the Stanley and Infineon. As you all know, we've got the ECC as well. Now just to what we're going to do today, so we're going to run the reciprocating machine for you guys, we're going to run the screw, you know, just to show you guys the noise levels, and then also you can see the difference and explain to you how the machines work exactly. So let's take it from here. You can see we've got the MAM 860 here. This controls the whole machine, it controls the safeties, the running hours, the loading hours. Got the start to stop there, emergency here, you can see it there. You can set all the parameters on the controller itself, and this basically monitors the machine safeties and the operations of the machine. If something should happen with the machine, the safeties automatically will send the signal through to the controller and the machine will shut off immediately. And that's it. Okay guys, so here we've got a rotary screw compressor, also known as a silent compressor. As you can see here, now it's open, now all the doors are open. You've got your electrical motor here, you've got here the air end, again also the motor, it runs the air end, you've got your air filter, your suction box, at the back here you've got the air oil separator vessel, you've got your cooling fan and you've got your electrical box there. On this side here we've got your electrical controller which basically controls the compressor itself. So just to explain to you in short, the air gets sucked through the air filter here, it goes through to the suction box, which regulates the amount of air that goes into the air end. The air end compresses the air. With the oil mixture, it goes through to the vessel here. This is basically what it says, air oil separator. The oil runs down to the vessel at the bottom there. The air goes out here, it goes through the aftercooler at this side here, which basically cools the air down before it goes to the outlet. So in short, this machines are also known for its low noise levels. They vary from 60 to 63 dB. Okay guys, so you can see now the machine is closed, the doors have been closed now. The reason for this is for the cooling. It's just more efficient. The fresh air gets sucked in from the side doors here, goes through the machine, through the air and the after cooler, the oil cooler at the back here. I'm going to run the machine now so you can hear the low noise levels. These machines, the noise levels run between 60 and 63 dB. They're also known as the silent compressors. So as you can hear now, the machine is running. It's running quite soft. We can still have a conversation. Just waiting for it to load. That's basically the loading of the machine. So now this machine is running on its maximum demand. The air outlet at the back, it's getting muffled. So that's the most noise that we will hear with the machine running. But if it's connected into a line, obviously there will be no noise levels. It's basically just the machine itself. As you can hear, we can still have a nice conversation. And now the machine is running. Okay, moving on to the reciprocating side. Here you've got your block, electrical motor, your air receiver. So the motor wheels the block on, the air goes through the air filters, it goes through into the cylinders, through the interstaging, and it goes out into your vessel, as you can see down there. So on this side, that side you've got your electrical, where the electrical connection goes. On this side you've got your switch, which runs the machine on and off. You've got your safety valve and your dial gauge here to show you the amount of air that's in the vessel. Okay, now I'm going to start the machine. You can hear the noise levels of it. These machines are commonly known to run between 90 and 96 dB on the noise levels. So I'm going to start this machine now so you can hear. You can hear it's much more noisier than the rotary screw machine. And this is basically what the machine runs at.